Hey guys, welcome back to Stoneheart with me, Banto, back in Alpha 5 with our City Gold Spring, and we're gonna try to fix some things for this episode, some things that's been going a bit wrong. So what we're going to do is the one thing that's very important. Since I wanted to improve like the defenses of our town, we wanted to improve it with creating better armor for our footmen, and the way that we do that is to actually create this thick leather vest, and for that we need two leather resources, which we are actually already crafting. And in the previous one we choose to make the wrong one. Yeah, there's some goblins going around here, so we gotta be careful so they do not come and like kill us. So we was making the wrong one here, which is actually the padded vest, and I made the correct one first, but then when it kind of screwed up a bit I made the wrong one. So you have to be careful, like, because sometimes when you go between these things, you kind of see the thing you want to do, but it is not actually that thing that you want to do. So, gotta be careful to make sure that you're actually crafting the thing you want to do. So, what we're gonna do is to create two of these thick leather vests. They require two leather resources each, and we're gonna make sure that we maintain things in the correct order. So, first thing we're gonna maintain is to make sure that we have thread, which we're using both for the cloth resource, which they're crafting now, which we try to have free in supply all the time. And after that they're gonna go and make some bundle of leather, and we're actually gonna change how the bundle of leather is made, because it's set to actually craft a specific amount. So we're gonna try to maintain two of these, and we have to make sure that it's below these before, because it's gonna go in this order from top to down. So that way we're making sure that we have leather so we can create the thick leather vest. And that's gonna improve our town really much, and I have some things that I'm gonna work out as well from the previous video, which one guy said on the comments about these tables here. Yeah, it does not look really like that good. It should be like one more table here, but if I place one more table here, we can like see how they're gonna look. It's gonna go a little bit too much to that side. I think that maybe if we place like this and like keep going, like, okay, it's like that. Let's move in forward actually, let's do it just to see how it's gonna look. So we're gonna move every single table, and after we've done that we're actually gonna remove the chairs as well. So let's see how this is gonna look. One deer and the other will be deer. So it's not actually gonna work out, it's should probably had one more block at the width of this place, so it's not gonna work out the way we want it. So, but we can leave it on the front here. Let's move that one as well. And let's move the chairs forward. And actually I have some plans to change around some things with this table here. So we're gonna go to it very soon when I move these chairs back and forth to the table. So that's good. But as you see, it's not gonna work out. If we put one here, it's gonna be going too much. It might actually look better than having it the way it is now, but yeah. So we're getting a lot of goblins invading, and do we have any improved footmen yet? Not sure. Where's our footmen? Where are they when we need them? Where are our footmen? Are they here? Okay, I think we have one footman here. Nope, that was the trapper. Okay, so let's unalert them and got a footman here. Where's the other one? We're supposed to have two of them. Here's the other one. So we're gonna get that thick leather vest soon, and it's gonna improve our city very much. As I get it, it should only like improve like the health or armor of the footman in the current stage of the game. So it shouldn't really like affect the damage of them, and it would be very unlogical if it did, since it's actually just making another armor for them, so they would be able to like take more hits. And it's really, really useful to have now, because we're getting invaded by way more goblins than we used to get invaded by, so it's definitely gonna help really, really much. So we should get started on the thing that I was talking about before with improving and changing how this house looks for a bit. So the one way we can do this is with making some fences. I'm actually gonna make, it's gonna be pretty mad, it's gonna be about 20 fences. And we're not gonna maintain them, because we know that the fences do bug out. They won't go to the stockpile, basically. So they will be like lying all around here, so that's why we're not gonna try to maintain them. It would just be infinite crafting, so One thing that I have noticed when I played as well is that you don't seem to be able to actually craft a trapper's knife, so if the trapper die, you have no trapper, you can't get a trapper. The only way, as I see it, that you could get a trapper is actually by getting a trader and trade something with them. Seems to be the only way, because if you go inside here, there's no trapper's knife. We got a wooden practice sword, we got a farmer's hoe, we got a weaver's spindle, nothing going on here. And it's the same for the weaver, pretty obvious that it shouldn't be at the weaver, but it's nothing here. So basically, try to be very safe with your trapper. I actually did lose a trapper before, and it seems like the trapper is actually getting attacked now. So come on, go help the trapper. I'm getting one to help. Can we get some more? Come on, footman. Yeah, that footman actually got some improved armor, so that's good. You can actually see it visually, and I think that's really good about the game, that it's not that they are just improved, you can actually see that this footman has the new leather vest, and you can also see it on the workers, like these two guys here, they actually have the improved clothing, which improves how fast the workers are moving around. And it does seem like it is with this outfit for the workers, that it only applies for normal workers, so I would think that this padded vest, which this tripled quilt vest provides more protection to your combat units than the mere clothing. Not a lot more, but every little bit helps, right? So I guess that's also for the combat units, but we also get this upgraded work outfit, and as I see it, it only seems to work for normal workers, so it does not work for like farmers, not carpenters, not trappers, just normal workers. And I guess the other one's gonna get something in the future as well. And here we got the fences I was talking about before that are very, very buggy in Alpha 5, but I think it's gonna get improved. So we're putting a fence on top of this roof slash floor balcony thing. It's gonna try to make it look a little bit more detailed, a little bit more nice. Gonna move two. I do not want to move too many at the same time, like too fast. I had problems kind of with it before, like they wouldn't place it, and you see this guy is getting stuck on top. He actually started to move, but sometimes people get stuck on top there, and sometimes they put fences above the other fence, and it screws up, so I would say go a little bit slow if you're gonna try something like this. Yes, to be safe. And also thinking about in the future, not really now, but not too far from now, make another town which is not gonna be like survival. So this town has the survival thing, we gotta protect ourselves against the goblins, so this actually has some difficulty to it. But the peaceful game, if we're gonna make a town with that, is just gonna be basically like we can try to make an awesome looking town. We of course gonna make sure that we have food for our people, but it's gonna be a lot about designing cool houses. So let's see what the trade wants. Hello, Goldspring, I'm just passing through, but even I can see that you have a skill craft in your ranks. If making 6 table of 1, I'll back 1 day so I might be able to give you 5 curtains. Yeah, let's do that. That's gonna be worth it. It does actually take quite amount of time to actually make cloth resources, even though we have like infinite amount of it. I noticed that it does take a lot of time for the weaver. If you only have one weaver, it does take a lot of time to make those things. So what we should do is to make this table for 1. I think it was 61, so let's make 8. No, let's make 10 of them. Doesn't hurt to have some extra. We should get down some woods as well. And by the way, I actually started to do some live streaming. So I'm doing some Stoneheart live streaming, like Age of Conan and other games. I'm thinking about doing many different games on my live stream, but it is B4NTO Sabanto on Twitch TV. So if you'd like to tune in and see when I'm streaming, maybe talk to me while I'm streaming, feel free to do so. I'm not having any like setup time for it for the moment, since I'm very, very like early in it. I had like one stream, I would say, that been like a serious stream when I was actually speaking with my viewers and such stuff, but it's really fun and looking forward to try that. So if you like to see that, go and check me out on Twitch, B4NTO. Yeah, it started to look pretty good with the fence on top there. But there are many, many ways you can customize, you can play around with these things and maybe look in a way that you didn't think it would be looking in. And this is not actually gonna look that good. We should have had one more block at here. You can see it looks pretty bad. And if I put it here, it's not gonna go together the way we want it, but I mean, we can have it like that. I don't wish to have it exactly like that, but you know, the building is already built, not much we can change about it. We can like destruct it, but you know, we're not gonna do that. Too much work put into it. What is this? The trapper, oh. Okay, we get some error message. I think we should do a save. Yeah. So, we get some armor. I think both footmen got improved armor defense. Do we have it? So, there's one and there's one. So we have the improved leather armor for both of them. That's great. It was actually really easy to make it. And the weaver seems to think that these throw rags are supposed to be thrown like this. So I guess it's the same like with the fences. So maybe we should place, let's place a rug. Let's place one in the tavern, and I guess we could place another one. And these you can have like below things, so I'm gonna make it like continue like this. Hopefully it can look pretty decent at least. I mean, the more like we make it, the more details we got to it, the better it looks, the more like, oh, this is actually a place where someone would live. That's nice. Oh, a lot of bad, nasty arrows. Wooden wall mounted lantern. Should we get some of them? Do we actually have... No, we actually do not have any lantern in this one. And I love lanterns. I love windows for my town. And here's his... Okay, it's bugging out. So let's do another save and load that guy up. So... And this solves so many bugs in this game. Loading a game, that solves so many bugs, so if you play this game, you run into some strange things, which you will do. Save and load. So, let's get inside, and it works again, and the lanterns are gone for some reason. We need to get more wood. We do lack a lot of wood. Okay, we're getting attacked. Where is our footman? Okay, I guess the goblin can have, like... A little bit of food. We have a lot of food, so... Go get them, footman. You should get outside. Come on, footman. Yeah, they ain't the most clever at times. Okay, we're getting invaded by a lot of goblins now, so... Only one of our footmen is actually here, and one is hanging around at the fire while we're getting attacked. And this is not good. I think we might actually be losing a footman. This is not good. So this is what will happen when the game kind of like decides to go its own way, like... If they would actually be working, like, see, they're real stupid standing around inside a house here. If the game would work like it's supposed to do, they will actually go out and fight. We can probably try to do a save here. Or we could even try to like load that game. Let's actually load the previous save. And then we might actually be able to defend ourselves, but it is really frustrating this stuff when it happens. We have enough defense, we have two footmen. Two footmen can hold them off easily. And together with other people, even easier, so. Hopefully this is gonna work out good. We get an incoming goblins. Yeah, they are coming, so I'm gonna leave them on alerted. That way they most likely can stay inside the town here and await them, so we're gonna be prepared for them when they are coming. There's two guys running over. Hopefully the other one's gonna come to help. But I kinda wish that I can control these footmen a lot more, like you could set a patrolling route for them so they can go between that place and patrol around. That would be really, really handy. But as you see, we're getting a lot more goblins attacking us, which are good that we made this thick leather armor, and it's gonna help really much. But guys, I think this is gonna be it for today with Stoneheart. I hope you enjoyed it. I hope the guys are enjoying the sleep in the woods here. But guys, thanks for watching. Hope you had a good time. And there's gonna be plenty of more Stoneheart episodes, both in survival and the peaceful mode, where we're gonna like try to like design some cool houses, some cool structures, like kind of go around, go nuts, and construct things. Which I will also do on my live stream from time to time when I will be playing Stoneheart. So guys, thanks for watching, hope you had a good time. Take care, cheers, goodbye, this is Banto, see ya.